Hi, I'm James Montemagno, a program manager on the .NET developer community team. Today, I want to show you how you can integrate menu bars into your desktop applications to make them world-class with .NET MAUI. So tune in. Hey everyone, I'm James, and today we're going to be talking about how to integrate menu bars into your desktop applications with .NET MAUI. Now, what exactly is a menu bar? Well, a menu bar is a bar that has different menu items in it. Now, if you've used any Windows applications, you may have noticed that these are integrated into the top of every single application. If you're on a Mac, these are going to be in the top status bar areas with different dropdowns. What's nice about menu bars is that they're very flexible, which means that you're able to have multiple sub-items, separators, and a lot more. And with .NET MAUI, it's really easy to integrate these into your applications. So let's create our very first menu bar items. So these menu bar items are the ones that show up at the top inside of your navigation page or in your shell navigation. So here we have a file, locations, and a view. These can be created in both the XAML and also inside of C# and any content page. So to create it, just like you would different toolbar items, you're going to use the contentPage.menuBarItems element. And what this does is it takes an array of different menu bar items that are associated with that specific page. So every page of your application can be dynamic and have different menu bar items. Here, what we've done is created three menu bars with the text of file, locations, and view. Of course, you can bind that to resource files so they're translated if your application is in different languages. Additionally, I'll show later how you can add icons into your menu bar items as well. All right, well, these are just the top level menu bar items. And the idea here is when you click on them, a menu comes down. So let's go ahead and now add a few different items. Here, we're going to add two items, refresh and change theme under the view menu bar item. We call these flyout items because they fly out when you tap on that specific menu bar. Here we go. All you have to do is put in the element of menu flyout item. Here inside of the menu bar item itself, a view, you can add as many as you'd like. So here we've added two with the text of refresh and change theme. Pretty simple. Now, in addition to just adding them, you can also add separators. This is a nice way if you want to group different pieces of functionality. So for example, under refresh, we might want to separate that from change theme. They're sort of different inherent actions that your users are going to take. And just like we added different menu bar items, we can add as many separators as we want. So here we've added a menu flyout separator between the two flyout items. And just like that, we have our separator inside of our project. Perfect. All right. Well, there's a lot more that you can do with menu bars, including sub-items. This is really great when you have an application that has a bunch of different complex functionality and that you want to group together. You don't want to clutter that one different menu item dropdown. You may want to here, for example, have a flyout option. So here under locations, we're going to say change location. You may have other ones underneath that, but we have this little chev, this little arrow that points to different locations. And again, we can define all of these in our code behind in C# or F# or in our XAML as well. So instead of adding a flyout menu item, we're going to add a menu flyout sub-item. And a sub-item is going to have a list of menu flyout items. So we kind of shift them around a little bit. The nice thing here is that each menu bar item knows that it can take different types of menu bar items, that separator, the flyout item, or the flyout sub item. Here we give it some text and then the menu flyout items inside the list to display. So here we're gonna display Berlin, London, and Redmond. Perfect. Now, additionally, we can have icons. So here on our menu for view of refresh, we can go ahead and use the font image source of the icon image source. Now, what I'm doing here is I'm using embedded fonts of Font Awesome to actually display a glyph in a specific color. So it will not only display our text of refresh, but we're also going to see that it will now display this glyph next to it. And you can, of course, use app theme bindings so that color changes dynamically with the theme of your application. So pretty awesome. Next up are events and commands. You want to do something when your user taps on one of those menu bar items. So it's really simple. You just add a clicked event to automatically register in your code behind that flyout item was selected. Now, if you're using MVVM and doing data binding to your XAML, you can also not only bind command, but also command parameters. So here, for example, I'm going to do a binding on the command to the refresh command that's in my view model that will automatically get triggered when the user taps on that. Finally, what I've shown so far is just what it looks like on Windows, but like I mentioned earlier, when you run that same exact code on a Mac, it will integrate deeply into the main menu system those on the top of Mac. So here we can see file locations and view. Now notice, because Mac applications have standard help and window and edit menus, those also show up there. So you need to take those into consideration. And of course, you can read through the documentation on how to customize the pre-built ones into every single Mac and Mac Catalyst applications. Well, that's it. You can get started today by going to .NET/Maui to learn everything about .NET Maui. And I will put links in the show notes below for everything that you need to know about getting started with menu bars. Hope that you enjoyed this video. Leave comments below. And don't forget to click like and subscribe for more videos right here on the .NET YouTube. Thanks for watching.